It was supposed to be a routine visitor, just another icy fragment from deep space passing by. But when 3, I/Atlas, hurtled past Mars at 130,000 miles per hour, and then, impossibly, stopped cold to orbit the planet, without a hint of heat or an engine in sight, NASA's most trusted analysts were left speechless. The sheer energy required was greater than every nuclear reactor on Earth running for years. Suddenly, the boundaries of science collapsed into dread. If natural law can break this spectacularly, what else is about to follow? This is how the story of 3I/Atlas suddenly stopped moving, and what happened next shocked NASA, begins. And what happened next, no one was prepared for. At 58 kilometers per second, 130,000 miles an hour, 3I/Atlas should have swept past Mars in less than a blink. That's the kind of speed that turns planets into roadside blurs, a velocity so extreme that even the fastest spacecraft built by humans would look stalled by comparison. According to mission logs, the object's approach was tracked by every available instrument. Its trajectory, calculated to a dozen decimal places, left no room for surprises. For a moment, the universe seemed to obey its own rules. Then, all at once, those rules broke. The numbers tell the story. To bring an object the size of a small mountain, hundreds of billions of tons, down from interstellar speed to a dead stop in the span of a few hours would require more energy than every nuclear reactor on Earth running at full power for years. No known propulsion system, not even the wildest concepts from theoretical physics, could account for such a maneuver. The object didn't slow down gradually, didn't spiral in or shed mass. It simply halted, as if inertia itself had been switched off. One mission dynamics analyst, reviewing the raw telemetry, described the event as a mechanical impossibility. The calculations didn't add up. There was no sign of catastrophic breakup, no shockwave, no debris cloud. The kinetic energy alone should have vaporized the object or left it glowing with the heat of re-entry. Yet, in the aftermath, 3I/Atlas remained whole and cold, locked in a stable orbit around Mars. The laws of motion, Newton's, Einstein's, anyone's, had been rewritten in real time. The implications rippled through every control room on Earth. If something could stop an interstellar object at will, the boundaries of technology and nature had just been erased, and no one could say what would happen next. Infrared sensors swept across the Martian sky, searching for the telltale glow of waste heat. According to every law of physics, an object that size, having just shed the energy of 1,000 nuclear arsenals, should have been blazing, pouring out radiation across the spectrum. Instead, the data came back blank. 3I/Atlas registered only a few degrees above the temperature of deep space. No infrared spike, no thermal bloom, not even a faint afterglow. The only visible sign was a brief blue-white emission, an instantaneous flash, too cold and too structured to match any known energetic release. One instrumentation specialist at the Jet Propulsion Laboratory described it as the cleanest energy event I've ever seen, if you can even call it energy. Under normal circumstances, a maneuver like that would produce catastrophic heating, stripping atoms from rock and metal, leaving a trail of plasma in its wake. But the surface of 3I/Atlas remained inert, its profile smooth and featureless, even under the most sensitive scans. The spectrographs picked up nothing but the faintest trace of ionization, with no evidence of chemical propellants or ablative shielding. The implications were staggering. To move that much mass that quickly, with no detectable waste heat or exhaust, suggested a system operating at nearly perfect efficiency, something far beyond fusion drives or theoretical antimatter engines. Engineers ran comparison models against every propulsion concept ever proposed, from solar sails to Alcubierre warps. None could account for the absence of heat. No human technology, real or imagined, could match the performance implied by those readings. The absence of waste heat was not just a puzzle. It was a message, A demonstration of control so precise, so deliberate, that the possibility of natural origin faded from every serious discussion. Whatever had stopped 3, I/Atlas above Mars, it was not an accident of physics. It was a statement of intent. And it left the scientific community with a single chilling question. What was the purpose behind such perfection?
Once settled in orbit, 3 I/Atlas began to act with an unsettling precision. Within minutes, Mars Reconnaissance Orbiter recorded bursts of structured electromagnetic pulses radiating outward from the object, regular, repeating, and far too organized to be natural. The pulses swept across the planet in a grid, each sequence lasting only a few seconds before shifting to a new longitude. A planetary geophysicist at JPL described the pattern as a full-spectrum X-ray of Mars run by something that knows exactly what it's looking for. 12 hours after orbital insertion, the pulses intensified over Cydonia, a region famous for the so-called face-on Mars MESA. Ground-penetrating radar aboard the Mars Express detected anomalous reflections, deep, layered scans that mapped several kilometers beneath the surface. The data showed a level of detail beyond anything achieved by human instruments, revealing hidden ice deposits, ancient lava tubes, and mineral signatures previously unknown. For the mission operations coordinator managing the Perseverance rover, the timing was impossible to ignore. 3 separate modules detached from 3I/Atlas and began controlled descents, each targeting locations within visual range of active NASA rovers. Over the next 2 days, at least 23 objects separated from the main structure. Some targeted the polar ice caps, others aimed for suspected subsurface aquifers, and a handful landed near regions rich in hydrated minerals. Each descent was tracked by radar and thermal sensors, but the modules vanished on contact. No surface disturbance, no debris, no radio echo. One geophysicist remarked, "It's as if the planet just absorbed them." Attempts to image the modules failed across every spectrum. Optical, infrared, and radar instruments all returned blank frames. The only constant was 3I/Atlas itself, still in orbit, still emitting faint electromagnetic patterns, silent, methodical, and unmistakably deliberate. Every action suggested reconnaissance, not randomness. And with each scan and landing, the sense grew that Mars was not the endpoint, but only the beginning. A sudden silence settled over mission control. For nearly a day, 3I/Atlas maintained its silent orbit, emitting only the faintest electromagnetic pulses, until a new pattern interrupted the static. SETI cryptographer Dr. Lena Ortiz was the first to recognize the structure, a sequence of prime numbers encoded in base 10, followed by a mathematical constant, P, calculated out to 24 decimal places. The sequence repeated, then shifted, as if waiting for a reply. Ortiz and her team responded with a transmission of their own, embedding the atomic numbers of hydrogen and oxygen, universal markers of water, into the return signal. Minutes later, 3I/Atlas answered. This time, the message was unmistakable, a grid of numbers that, when plotted, formed the outline of Earth's continents and major oceans. Superimposed on the map was a faint overlay, a military satellite network, annotated with orbital periods and ground tracks. One Pentagon analyst described the moment as the most precise targeting data we've ever seen, and it wasn't ours. Within hours, U.S. Space Command confirmed a shift in 3I/Atlas's trajectory. Orbital calculations showed a slingshot maneuver using Mars's gravity, redirecting the object onto a path that would intersect Earth's orbit in just under 7 weeks. The intercept window was narrow, less than 18 hours. Yet the predicted course passed within 50,000 kilometers of the planet's surface, well inside the geostationary belt. Contingency directives were drafted in classified sessions, and the world's major observatories went dark,
their data streams encrypted and rerouted through military channels. A single chilling question hung in the air. Was this a reconnaissance mission gone further, or the opening move in something far more deliberate? As encrypted transmissions pulsed between agencies and orbital predictions narrowed with each hour, one fact remained inescapable. 3I Atlas was no longer a distant curiosity. It was coming home.
In just under 7 minutes, 3I/Atlas decelerated from 130,000 miles per hour to a stable orbit around Mars, without any detectable heat signature. NASA's logs confirmed targeted electromagnetic scans of the Martian surface and the deployment of 23 modules, each tracked by multiple international agencies. The decoded mathematical message, referencing a detailed map of Earth's military infrastructure, is archived in joint NASA and SETI communication records. Yet, the propulsion method, the true function of those modules, and the ultimate intent behind the message remain classified or unknown. As of the last confirmed orbital recalculation, 3I/Atlas is on a trajectory that intersects with Earth's orbit within weeks, according to US Space Command and ESA bulletins. What began as a routine observation has forced agencies worldwide to share data and resources in real time. All that is certain, 3I/Atlas has rewritten the boundaries of what we know and revealed how much we still do not know.